हेलो, अ वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू यू ऑल विटर्स। हाउ यू ऑल होप एंजॉयिंग योर स्टडीज, ऑनलाइन स्टडीज दैट वी आर डूइंग। आई थिंक चैप्टर वन वी हैव कंप्लीटेड, इजंट इट, एंड चैप्टर टू वी हैव स्टार्टेड। सो टिल नाउ इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट्स यू कैन आस्क मी, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल थिंग। सेकेंड, एज आई एम गिविंग यू द वर्क दैट मस्ट बी कंप्लीटेड बाई यू ऑन टाइम। Third is that you should complete that properly in your notebook so that it don't be confused. You should not be confused with that. Okay. So as yesterday we have started nutrition in animals. That is about the we can say modes of way how they used to catch their prey like amoeba, frogs, mosquitoes, eagles, snakes, and all that. Okay. Now what is that? Today we are going to deal with the next topic, that is steps in nutrition. See over here you can see steps in nutrition, different types of nutrition's way, that is ingestion, digestion. On the next page further we will read about assimilation, observation and ejection. Okay, so now what does that step in nutrition means how a way of taking food till taking out the waste products, that we are going to study over here. You know that on the daily side if we see that we used to take our food from even the human beings or animals, they are supposed to take food from out and used to release the undigested food daily wise. Okay, so majority of animals take food in the form of solids. The food which you are taking is usually in the form of solids. Okay, but while as you enter the piece of food into your mouth with the help of saliva, it changes, isn't it? It becomes in a liquidy form. Okay, so this form of nutrition in which food is eaten in solid form is known as holozoic nutrition. Clear? As the food eaten consists of complex substances such as carbohydrates and proteins. Beforehand only we have read out that carbohydrates may be complex also. Simples we are called that are sugar, and complex one used to be in the form of starch. These are broken down in the animal body to utilize the nutrients. What does this means? As we are taking any food, to eat, the food provides us energy to do the work. So that is why the proteins or carbohydrates which they are taking, they are broken down in itself in animal's body and they utilize that nutrients. Okay. The process of obtaining food, mode of intake of food and its utilization in the body of growth and development is called nutrition. So overall how can we define nutrition? That the way we are taking food. First, second, how we are taking the food, and third, what is the food intake after taking food, what utilization our body accepts from that food for our growth and development is overall called the nutrition. Now the next comes, what are the following process? You know that all the process of nutrition happens only in heterotrophs. Why? Because autotrophs are the green plants, they used to prepare their own food on self. Okay, but in heterotrophs they need food from other, they take the use of help of plants or animals for preparing food. Now what is ingestion? Ingestion, with the word ingestion it can be just verified that we are taking the food inside our, inside the body of an organism. Okay, so that is a thing, the process by which food is taken inside the body of an organism is called ingestion. Next comes is digestion. What does the word digestion, you know? What you can feel that what does the word digestion suggest? Actually, the word digestion means it's we can say the food which we have taken at that time it is solid, but as it's moved to inwarding and as our body, my stomach releases some juices, digestive juices, which by which the mixing with them, that solid matters used to convert into soluble, simpler and soluble, and that is digest and just taken by our body. Exactly, we can say this process as a digestion. So come read, the food taken in is solid and complex. The process of converting or breaking down complex food into simple and soluble form is called digestion. Most animals use both physical and chemical methods for converting the complex food into simpler soluble form. So this is a way we can say how the food, complex food, is just converted into simple and soluble form that can be digested by our body. Next comes is absorption. What does the word absorption means? So absorption means it is the process by which digested nutrients are taken to different parts of the body by the circulatory system through blood. The cells in the body then absorbs this digested food molecules. Now what happens in absorption? The circulatory system comes. What does that circulatory system means? It is a, we can say, comprised of the heart, lungs and all the arteries and veins through which what happens, through the circulation of that, blood circulates all that nutrients from our body, which is absorbed by the cells in our body, and this is the process we call absorption. Absorption means just to shock like that from the blood, they are just taking this types of soluble ingredients so that we can use of this for us to do our work properly. The next comes is assimilation. What does assimilation means? It is the just process of using that absorbed food molecules for producing energy and growth. Actually, it's a vice versa. First, the step comes is ingestion, that is we used to take. Then the digestion, as we digest the food, from there what the soluble, that nutrients just move on, that are converted, that are used by our body, are then transferred through our body by the circulatory system. That is through the blood only this happens, and in this sense the cells in the body then absorbs this digested food molecules so that we can work properly. After that, assimilation is that process in which the same absorbed food, of which is just absorbed by our cells of body, is used for producing energy and growth. The last comes is egestion. Egestion, that is, what is egestion? The removal of undigested food materials from the body is called egestion. Clear? Undigested food materials, that means whatever we are eating, how much we want to eat, we can eat. The portion of our body, food which is digested with the soluble, which is digested or converted by our body, then it is utilized. But the remaining is used to be removed out of the body, and that is the process we call digestion. The basic steps of nutrition in animals are the same for all the animals, whether it is microscopic unicellular organism such as amoeba or either a complex multicellular human being. However, the way each step is carried out different in different animals. That means different type of animals having different, we can say particulars in their, or we can say the way they used to move like that. Amoeba being a microscopic unicellular organism, it's so small that further we are going to discuss about amoeba. But as it's a microscopic unicellular organism, in comparison to that, we are complex human being. We have different types of ways to consume the same food and digest the undigested food. Same process is going on amoeba also. So in different types of animals, different ways are there to complete. Now what happens on that basis? I am giving you a work. Here is work for you. See, self-check questions. Okay, so define the following. Ingestion, you know, the process by which food is taken inside the body of an organism is called ingestion. Second, assimilation, it is a process by which the absorbed food molecules for producing energy and growth. Digestion is the process of converting or breaking down complex food into simple and soluble form is called digestion. Absorption is the process by which the digested nutrients are just taken to different parts of the body with the help of or by the help of circulatory system, that is through blood. Last is ingestion, is the process of removing undigested food materials from our body, that is called ingestion. So here we complete our 5 important steps in nutrition, and the definitions I have already reminded you once again. Second question is, name the organs of ingestion in the following organism. That is, you have to name the organs how this organisms used to take, like that amoeba. It's a false feet, pseudopodia. They having false feet, pseudopodia, with that help they used to catch its prey. Butterfly, feeding tube. Frog, long sticky tongue. And last, rider is the sucking stomach. He used to webs a web. In that, he just injects some digestive juices where the insects stuck on the web. Okay, so just completing today's steps in nutrition and self-check question will be your homework. Now what you have to do, you have to go through the section which we have completed today. Second thing, the very next day, that on Monday, we are going to discuss about the food, that is nutrition in amoeba. See, it's here how a process of nutrition takes place. I have already explained you once, but again I am going to explain you. Okay, so go through the section properly, so that while when we are just going through with the book, it will be easier for you to understand the topic. Okay, so complete your work with a neat handwriting and just submit it to the your online teaching classes. And second, have a nice day for today. But for tomorrow, again we are going to study with your book. You should, so as you are sitting for your study, should keep your book in your hand so that you can study well. Because for your betterment only, we are just going through the book so that you can understand line by line and step by step from the book itself. Okay, thank you for today. Have a nice day, dears.